In this video, I'll walk through an example of finding the percent yield in a chemical reaction. Consider the following reaction. CaF2 plus H2SO4 yields CaSO4 plus 2HF. That's hydrogen fluoride. In one process, 4.25 kilograms of CaF2 are treated with an excess of H2SO4 and yield 1.95 kilograms of HF. Calculate the percent yield of HF, hydrogen fluoride. Here I've written this down. The percent yield equals the actual yield divided by the theoretical yield times 100%. So what's happening is, in chemical reactions, you have this theoretical yield based on this equation. And that's if everything is perfect. But the reality is that not everything is going to react all the time. So we have some percent yield, and we're going to turn out maybe only 50% of what you think is going to happen. Think of it this way. Lighting a firecracker when you're a kid, theoretically, they all go off, but some of them don't. There are duds. That's not exactly what's happening, but you can think of that analogy, that not everything is reacting as in theory. So, here's what we're going to do. We're going to convert this given 4.25 kilograms into the number of moles. So we have 4,250 grams, because they give us kilograms, but we're going to go with grams right away of this CaF2. And the reason I'm writing it in grams is because we need to convert this into moles, and the periodic table gives us the molar mass of each element in grams. So for every 1 mole of this substance, CaF2, we have a molecular mass of Ca, which is calcium, has a molar mass of 40.08, and fluorine. So that's 2 times the molar mass of fluorine, which is 38, or which is 19. So 2 times that is 38. So which gives us a molecular mass of 78.01 grams. Grams cancel out, and we have approximately 54.431, and some digits go on. I've just rounded it there. Don't round too early. Hang on to all these in your calculator. Hang on to all of your decimal places until the end. Only round at the end. Okay, now we have that many moles of this CaF2, but guess what? We are reacting that and yielding 2 moles of the hydrogen fluoride. So we need twice as much. We're going to get, this will yield twice as many moles of the HF. It's because of this. For every 1 mole of CaF2, we get 2 moles of HF, hydrogen fluoride. So we're going to do that. We're going to just take the 54.431 and multiply that by 2. We've got some extra decimals in the calculators held onto it, and we get 108. We will yield 108.8627 moles of HF. That's our yield, theoretical. We better say right now that is the theoretical yield. That is, if we had, in a perfect situation, and we have this much CaF2, calcium difluoride, then we would get this much hydrogen fluoride, the HF, and that's theoretically. But we got 1.95 kilograms. So let's first convert this into kilograms. So 108.8627 moles of the HF. And we need the molecular mass again. Now I'm going to put moles in the denominator because I want to cancel out the moles and convert to grams. So the molecular mass of HF is 20.008. That's one hydrogen and one fluorine. So approximately 2,178.125 grams of this. That's our theoretical yield. So using this formula, let's just plug and chug here. Our actual yield, which is the 1.95 kilograms or 1,950 grams. Let's change colors here. We get 1,950 grams is our actual yield divided by our theoretical yield, 2,178.125 grams. And that gives us a percent. Let's just multiply it by 100% right now. And that gives us, I'll round here, to 89.5% yield. Maybe that's good, maybe that's bad for this process in making hydrogen fluoride, but we have not reacted everything. We've just gotten 89.5% of what we thought we would get theoretically. If you found this video helpful, as always, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.